It's like Christmas in our kitchen. Why? Because we're going to make the chicken shish kebab. Woohoo! Yes, Turkish chicken shish kebab is really watery, fulfilling, and it's not just the chicken, it's the things that like the pilav and the vegetables you eat together, which makes it a big, big feast. Trust me, I can be one of those people in the whole world which will show you the way to make that soft chicken amazingly. We need chicken thighs. We have a kilo of chicken thighs. When they are deboned, they are like this in Turkey, without the skin. What we do, I'm going to cut this into 6 pieces. First, longitudinal, English 101. Then 2 pieces vertically like this. Basically, we have 6 chunks like this. And because it's thighs, some parts is thinner, some parts is thicker. And we have still these fats on, which makes it taste greater. It will disappear eventually when it's cooking, but it will give all the taste to the meat. So like this, I'm going to cut all of them. I have to show you this, guys. I got this thing from IKEA, you know, always cleaning the chicken is a mess. And this is now for chicken, this thin plastic board. It doesn't take a lot of place in the kitchen and I liked it very much, so I wanted to share it with you. It's not an ad. All of them together, they are here. We have a lot of sayings about the tail, and unfortunately my cat broke her tail and she became this very aggressive cat for a while. Now I understand that tail is very, very important, and we have many sayings like kuyruk acısı, tail pain. When someone is like kind of grudged, acts weirdly, oh don't worry about him, he has this tail pain. There's one saying. And the other thing is dananın kuyruğunun koptuğu an. It's the moment when the cow's tail is torn apart. And it means it's the moment. I don't know where this came from. Now it's the moment. I'm going to show you why this chicken is going to be perfect and how. Here comes the marinade. I'm going to get one onion and I'm going to puree it. Now it's a total puree, but I'm not crazy enough to open it right now because the onion vapor is going to kill my eyes. It will sit. What does the onion do? It tenderizes because of the acids. There's another acid that I love using, and it's yogurt. If you don't have yogurt, you can use cream or milk, depending on which one you have. I have 2 tablespoons of yogurt, 1 tablespoon of salt, and 1 tablespoon of black pepper. What I do, I grind my own pepper so that the taste increases. And also I'm going to use cumin. Cumin is very magical. It changes the taste. It makes it more meaty. And I have 2 tablespoons of cumin. It's a little heap. It's not like this. I think this is called leveled. It's not leveled. It's almost 2 times the level 1. And if you have red pepper paste and tomato paste, you can use those. But if you don't have it, you can use cayenne. And I have hot and sweet cayenne peppers. And I'm going to put a lot of olive oil, which is like this, 8 tablespoons of olive oil. And this is the new olive oil, oh my God. This will first wake up the herbs, and then after the acid opens their cells, it will help the taste to get into the chickens. And finally, we have a lot of garlic, 4 big cloves of garlic. And I'm going to put a bit more salt on this and make it a puree. Every time I do this, like crush the garlic like this, I feel funny because years and years ago, when I first made my TV show in Turkish, probably I was the first person on TV which crushed the garlic like this. And now 10 years and everything changed so much. Now in Turkey we have, I think, 2 or 3 cooking channels. Now all the garlics are done. All I have to do is to mix all these things together. You might say, Refika, cumin, are you crazy? So no worries, don't be afraid. It will make it really, really good. And what it's missing is, now I put the onion in and...
Why is it?
Because it's going to be little crunchiness and I don't want it in the chicken. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to use the water. Only this is left and a lot of water, as you can see, of the onion. And this beauty, after I mix it really, really well, it's going to sit in the refrigerator overnight. It will be tenderized, it will smell great, and when you cook it, it will be tasting great. Eight, nine, ten. Now I can eat a portion of this chicken kebab. If you ask me what this is actually is my shish box. This is how the people of Antep do their shish. Now, here I have lots of different shish. They differ in sizes. We have the smallest one, usually for liver. Mid-size for meats like that. And the biggest one is this one, mostly used for patlıcan kebab, which is eggplant kebab.
Ooh, yes. We'll do that someday, no?
We'll do that someday when the summer is closer and it's time for eggplants.
Why are they triangular?
Why are they triangular is the most important thing, because usually it's either square or just flat. What it does is, for example, when you put this shish, actually you can heat 120 degrees of the meat. You cannot like go to the sides. When it's square, it's 90 degrees, so you cook some parts double. But when it's a triangle, it's the perfect way to cook it. You know, we have a brand called Refika'dan. Soon I want to sell these in Refika'dan as well. They're not ready yet. Then they will be in Etsy, then later on in Amazon, hopefully. But these are amazing, and people of Antep, they are crazy about their kebabs. Even though they're living in an apartment, like in the third floor, they have their barbecue in front of their windows. They don't need a specific reason to make kebab. They can make it anytime. If they can, we can, guys. So from yesterday, I marinated the chicken the same way, the recipe that I've done. And here I have the same recipe, but without the paprikas. Instead of the paprikas, I have 2 tablespoons of pepper and tomato paste. This is also very good. But if you do this, please don't forget to decrease the salt a little bit, because it becomes very salty. This is a little tastier, I should say. I know that you ask all the time what pepper paste is. We have a video for it, by the way. You can make a barbecue and make the shish. It's going to be great. But I have another technique. If you watched my Adana kebab recipe, you might be familiar with my technique. I'm going to use my cast iron as barbecue. If the meat touches the bottom, it loses its water more. So treat it as like coal, and I'm going to put the shish on top and turn it that way. And it's going to cook maybe 2-3 minutes later, but it's going to be juicier than if the meat touches the surface. And I should say there will be a lot of smoke. I know some people have woken their smoke alarms. If you have aspirators, turn it on. If you don't, hope your kitchen has a window. So I start. If it's like a square, I put it through the middle. If you don't have metal shish, you can use wooden shish, but it's better if you put it into water night before as well, so that it will soak water and it won't burn a lot. For example, this piece is very long, and when you put it, it's not going to be very pleasant. Put the shish a little higher like this, and then fold it and put it like this so that it's going to be like the others. And don't get carried on and exceed the pan. You can check it like this, okay. Super. Now it will start to cook. And we do the rest together with Burak. Another thing is we shouldn't squeeze them. You can make it like this, very squeezed. Mm-hmm. And but then it will cook harder. Let there be air between them. 8, 9 for 20 centimeters. While you're cooking the kebab, another thing that is important is always you turn it. It's not like cook one side and flip it on the other. No. Kitchen is under the smoke a bit. Now, what I'm going to do, what is very tasty, is not just the meat itself, but together with the meat, There are herbs, mint, parsley. Also, these peppers, when they're grilled, they become very nice, very tasty. I'm going to put this at the bottom of the chickens so that it will absorb the taste of the juices of the chicken so well, and they will be really tasty. Now, we have the tomatoes, but because my tray is full, I'm going to put it into another one. I keep the green parts and cut it from the middle, like this. And when I'm putting them on the grill, I'm going to put the tomatoes skin side down. This way, this part is going to be grilled and it will have that smoky taste. And towards the end, I'm going to make the tomatoes together with the chicken so that it also absorbs this cooked chicken taste. I know for a lot of people in the world, raw onion is not so easy to eat, but it's very good. As I said, like the sourness with the kebab works in miracles. But if you are like that person, ooh, it's too hard for me, then I made something new. This is not traditionally done in Turkey. I cut the onion in half so that there will be half circles, and I'm going to thickly slice them and then rub them a bit. In the last minute, when I remove all the chickens, I'm going to put these raw onions so they will cook a bit. And together with that, if you're a garlic lover like I am, I'm going to put a lot of garlic to the bottom. The first survivors are here. The smell is incredible. I distribute the onions. I'm going to put back the chickens to here again. How do I understand that my chicken is not cooked yet? The test is, from the middle, try to pull the chicken. If it pulls apart, then it's done. As you can see, it's not like that yet. It needs like 5 more minutes. And I'll show you how it's going to be. And also how the onions are traditionally done. I also want to show you that. I'm going to cut one big onion to 4 pieces like this, keeping the top there so that it will be together. So this time I'm going to put the watery part down to the plate. Now, after, as you can see, some part is brown, I'm going to turn to the other side. So after a while, I collect all the rest of the onions as well. Now, I'm going to get all the tomatoes. The reason I told you about the tail story was, between these chickens, sometimes in the kebab stores they put tail fat. Like this is the tail fat, and several shish, and then tail fat, several. And this is actually from lamb, and it gives you that incredible taste. But it's really hard to find, I know, in many parts of the world. And what I wanted to do, I didn't want to lean on the fat to give us the taste, but I wanted to lean on the marinade, so more cumin and different ingredients, and letting it sit for a day. Now, time to check whether it's cooked again. It's been cooking about 15-18 minutes, and look how juicy it is still. And when you pull it, it's so softly coming to me. Another thing to check is, this might be an extra, put it in a lavash and then roll it and taste it. Is it soft? Is it juicy? Done. If it's starting to dry, then you're already late. Finally, take your shish, put your lavash and heat your lavash. Shiz actually, others too. And if you want to make your own lavash, we have a recipe for it. And here it comes. Look at this, guys. Heaven on earth. Wow. Here we go, voila. Also, Burak has incredible pilav. And with this chicken, this is my father's pilav recipe. One day, if you want, please tell us. I'm going to teach you how to make this as well. It's bulgur pilavı, and it's very tasty. So, that's it for today. I'm also going to make a serving, one serving out of this. And if you want, for your friends, you can make each person a serving. Now, how to eat this? As you can see, we have this lavash, which is becoming more tasty with the juices of the chicken. I'm going to have this one and take like three pieces like this, okay? And add some onions, some peppers to do, and some tomatoes.
Who is the lucky guy?
Lucky person? Me? I haven't eaten lunch since 3 o'clock. Can I?
Yes, yes. How is it?
I didn't understand. I have to eat more. I should tell you, I become really proud in the end. It becomes this. Guys,
best place where chicken shish can come.
Hope you like this recipe. Truly, I really enjoyed making it and I'm going to enjoy eating the rest of it with the crew. Hope you like it too. And by the way, 6 servings for the recipe that I've given. Hope you enjoy it as much as we did and maybe even more if you do. Please tell it to us under the comments and also please subscribe if you haven't, because that's how the word spreads. Take great care.